Hi, it's Yankor again. Okay, so we used specifically these discs to reallocate ourselves in different planets or wherever we want to go. You stand on the disc, see where you want to go, see yourself there, and you're there. It's quite simple. That we studied and learned, of course. Then there's Satra that still existed during that time. Satra is, Jesus, she's probably one of the oldest in existence. I mean, she was there even since the beginning when I was small. She's really the one that remained. It's fascinating through everything. So she was the one responsible for, you know, showing the children the galaxies and things like that. During that time, I was still small. So only the older children could go on the spaceships, you know, and travel different galaxies, different universes, different planets, etc. I was still the one only learning the information of it. But I've never actually seen one. So I went in with my friend and we did the whole disc reallocate their planet thing. And I was there for quite a while. Until finally, one day, spaceship arrives. Spacecraft. We don't call it spaceship, spacecraft. It was beautiful. Magnificent. I just sweat. I have to go on to it. What was strange was these races never really stopped the planets. They never really, you know, stopped the ships on planets, which is strange. So I figure out a way of how the hell I'm going to get onto one of those things. Because I'm going to get on it. I want to experience myself on it. Then I realized, well, this plan of mine is not going to work. I'm not going to get onto the ship like this. I have to find a different way. So, I realized one thing that exists is patience. Because I know inevitably I'll be old enough to have Satra take me on the ship to visit other planets and other galaxies. So let me first get to know existence from that perspective. Then, when I'm old enough, I'll create my own spaceship. Why not? I don't know how I was going to do it. I don't know how it would be possible, but I knew that's what I'm doing. So, I said fine. I went back to my planet and remained there until I got older. It's strange. It's not that time exists. You expand according to your knowledge and information intake and how you apply that in your daily life and, you know, what it is that you do and, you know, how you show and how you assist others to understand what it is that you're able to do. That's how you age. But it's a natural occurrence, so it happens automatically. Age from that perspective or growing up from that perspective is never really an issue for anyone. For me, of course, it was. So I did my best to grow up, you know, as fast as possible. Then the time came where Satya finally said, right, first day, going to go and explore the universes, the galaxies, the planets. She had this like big spacecraft. But it wasn't really a spacecraft. It wasn't one that I would have gone, oh yes, you know, this is the one I'd like to experience myself on. No, it was more, it was a round flat spacecraft. It was, of course, fucking huge. Spacecraft, flat. Then you're able to stand inside it. It had like a, you know, for you to be able to stand in, you know, you have like, what do you call it? You have like these boats that you climb inside it and you just got the edge around it and you can still look outside. Okay? And not taking it into comparison with that boat, I'm just saying what it looked, what you're able to do when you climb into that spacecraft. So you climb in, it's huge, flat, round, and that's where you move on. And then from there, you know, she traveled with us to different planets. First thing I Yankor asked was, Satya, take us to the planet with all the spaceships. Then she said to me something interesting. She said, usually, planets with races that exist in spacecraft don't have planets. She said, but that doesn't make sense. Where do they come from? And they said the spacecrafts are in the manifestation of a being. No, how does that work? Because, you know, spacecraft is a spacecraft. I'm going to be a being. She said, how else do you think spacecrafts are developed, Yankor? I was saying, but you know, common sense would probably be that they're building it off something. I mean, what are planets in existence? Are planets beings? You won't believe the bloody answer. It says to me, yes. Planets are also beings. I was like, what? So you're telling my planet is a being? Well, why doesn't it speak then? She said, have you ever spoken to it? Of course. I said, no. I said, why doesn't it speak to us? Because it's such a thing, it doesn't need to speak. So I started learning more about what it is this universe actually started consisting of. Then, there was how the hell did that happen to be beings? And then apparently, it has something to do with the Anunnaki imprisoning beings who had done something to their race and their planet, and they manifested them as beings, as a prison for the remainder of their existence, on which other races are able to make their living, things like that. So it's quite interesting. Now, on the spacecraft topic, Sister, now I want to go on one of those. Please. She said to me, no, you're not ready yet. I did not accept that answer. So, now I knew during that time was a being with connections. He rarely went to school. It's not really that it was school, you know, it was more you learned about your existence, you know. And he was rarely there, because his father, his family base placement, they were seen as the most important beings in existence, you know, not like kings or gods or governors, like government thing that you have here on Earth. No, they were just important, you know, because they were the creators, so they were seen as the creators. Of course, to me, it was irrelevant. I just saw everything as what it is, what it was, but Anu's placement was specific. So, I went to give Anu a visit. Now, Anu was like, he was, you know, those nerdy scientists you'd get, you know, always in the basement, developing things, creating things. Yeah, that was him. Seemed innocent. But I had fun with him. I enjoyed him. You know, he was quite smart. He created and manifested quite interesting things. He always wanted to take it one step further. You know, he always wanted to be better than someone else the whole time. So he'd always advance in his explorations and manifestation and creations. So I went to him because I knew him and his father and his family and things, and most connections to all the galaxies and universes and planets. So I asked him, Anu, I want to get on a spaceship, goddammit, take me on a fucking spaceship. And he just looked at me and he said to me, I'll arrange. Thank God. So what he arranged for me was this small little spaceship, really small. And he said to me, I can have it because this was like the real old models. This is your first one. So it was quite an interesting make, though, expression. So I will tell you about the history of my first spaceship a bit later.